Utilising expat skills. This works for both Spain, Philippines, or wherever. The expat community have a very broad selection of skills, but often they don't use them. I know some people are quite happy just sitting in the sun doing nothing, but there's a lot of stuff they could be doing constructively for the benefit of each other. For example, if somebody still does construction work or a bit short on cash and wants to go back to doing construction work, if you know that they're good at it, there's nothing wrong with utilising them for it. They make a bit of money and you get you guaranteed quality. In the same way, like here in Spain, our little expat services. At the moment, we've got myself who does building and property management, but we've got Andre that does the legal side and translation services. We've got Andy that does web development and web design, and we've got Igor that does construction and renovations. And we also have the car hire and airport runs. But that's just the starting point. Because I was talking to Nick, who does all the printing for us. He doesn't really advertise online or anything, so I'm going to help him develop his stuff online. Because although he's very, very busy, I want to try and help him develop his business. But the whole point is, you work together. Because if you want to get on and actually be successful, you rely on each other. One of the problems in Spain, I find, is, especially with the Brits, a lot of people use a lot of the Spanish services and get ripped off. And I'm not saying that in a negative way, but the point is, if you, a lot of Brits within the community would do a better service because they're worried about the flack they get from the expats. So in that sense, you're sort of guaranteed a good service because the person who's doing it knows they'll never hear the end of it otherwise. Where if it's a Spanish, like the mechanic we have here, the one I used before, he double charged me. But also, I was talking to somebody else the other day, and they said they couldn't even fix his car. Not because it's got something major with it, they just didn't know how to fix it. The same way I had the hoses between the different pistons. It was a simple thing, it only cost me about, I think, 4 or 6 euros to fix. They wanted to change the entire fuel pump, which was hundreds. That's why it's important to work together. You want to try and help each other, not hinder each other. If somebody's doing well, it shouldn't really have a negative viewpoint from you. You should actually say, well, good on you. You've actually managed to kickstart something in a new country without, you know, without too much difficulty. Or if you've had difficulty, maybe they can help you with filling in the forms and the requirements and the certification and everything to get operational yourself and whatever you do. Because if you set up a business in the Philippines, for example, same as Spain, you're going to need your fire permits, mayor's permits, particular licenses relating to whatever you're doing. And that's why you have to prepare yourself for it, because it's not an easy feat sometimes. But if somebody's already invested that time and money in it, it's not really a problem to actually go over it and utilise their information or use their lawyer, because their lawyer will already know the costs of everything. So if you're going to go and do a similar business in a different area, I mean, that's the other thing. If Joe Bloggs is a hairdresser up in Manila, and the enterprise he's got there works really well, they may have no issue with actually helping you set up in Cebu, Davao, Dumaguete, or whatever, doing exactly the same. To the point they may even share the brand with you, so that it benefits both of you. That's why I say expats should work together. Now, you know, it benefits all parties involved. Thanks for watching.